Hello! In this video, we will go over how to register for classes. To begin, you will go to the necc.mass.edu website. Then, you will go ahead and click on the My NECC link near the middle of the homepage. Now, you will enter your student ID number and password in order to access your My NECC portal. If for some reason you have forgotten your password, you can come on down here to Student Password Manager to get that changed. Let's go ahead and click Login. You have now entered your portal. As an NECC student, there are three steps you need to take for advising and registration: planning for courses, reviewing with your advisor, and registering online. As part of planning for courses, your first step is to take a look at your DegreeWorks audit. If you scroll down to Student Frequently Used Tools, you will find it right here and go ahead and click. DegreeWorks will show you a lot of useful information. First, you can locate your advisor over here, and when you click it, you'll be able to email them directly. Here, you can view any potential holds on your account. If for some reason you do have any holds that are preventing you from registering, go ahead and reach out to your advisor and they will explain to you how to resolve it. Next, you will be able to see your degree audit, which will show you which classes you need to graduate from your program. Here in your degree audit, you can see all the courses laid out, where in yellow, you can see courses that you have completed a grade in at Northern Essex or transferred in from another school. In red, you can see courses you still need to complete your degree. And if you see anything in blue, those are courses that are currently in progress. You will want to keep this screen up so you can reference it during the registration process. Next, I will show you where to find your academic pathway. You will first return to the My NECC portal tab that you logged into previously. Then, under Student Frequently Used Tools, you'll scroll down just a bit further to Academic Catalog. The Academic Catalog is a very important tool that includes program and major information, policies, the academic calendar, and much more. To find your academic pathway, go ahead and scroll on the left side of the screen to Academic Programs and click. In there, you will look for your major. For the purposes of our example, we're going to select business. And in here, you can see all the different options for associate's degrees and certificates in the business category. For our example, we will select accounting. As you scroll down, you will see all of the requirements for your program listed. Then scroll down a little bit further and you will see a recommended course sequence or pathway. This will show you what classes you are supposed to take for your major, as well as a recommendation for which order you should take them in. Using both your DegreeWorks audit and academic pathway together will help you determine what classes you should complete this semester. Contact your advisor for any questions about the courses you are planning to take. You will also want to keep this screen up to reference it during registration. Now it is time to register. Please return to the My NECC portal tab you initially logged into. Then you will scroll down and click on the button that says Search and Register. This will take you into Self-Service Banner, where you will now click on the Register for Classes link near the top right. Then you will select the term that you wish to register for and click to continue. You will then be brought to a screen where you will search for classes. Don't forget that you will be picking your classes based on your DegreeWorks audit, your academic pathway, and any conversations that you have had with an advisor. Now you will begin to search for the subject and course number, if you have it, that you are looking to take. So for example, we'll type in English 101, which is English Composition 1. And if you would like to narrow down your choices based on your preferences, you can select Advanced Search. You can adjust this bar to have more space or less space. And as you scroll down, you have options to narrow your choices down by instructor, campus, day of the week, and time. For our purposes, we'll try selecting Tuesdays and Thursdays, and then click to search. Now you're able to see all the options for the English composition course that are just on Tuesdays and Thursdays. Let's take a closer look at this screen. Hover over the specific class section, and it will describe its name, number of credit hours, and it will tell you the day, time, place, and date of the class in the box. It's very important that you pay close attention to the start date and the end date of the classes, because at NECC, we offer 4 and 8 week classes in addition to the full 16 week semester courses. Now, we will go ahead and scroll through the courses to see if we can find a section that will work with our schedule. As I scroll down, I'm noticing there is a time conflict. Why? Well, over here, if we take a look in the schedule box, you can see that I already registered for a class on Tuesdays and Thursdays at 11 o'clock. So that means I need to select a section that will work around that class. As I go back over here, I see that there's an 8 o'clock section of English Comp, and since I don't have anything in that time slot over here, I can go ahead and click to add the course. Now it'll say web registered pending. If I decide that these two classes are all the classes I need and want to take, I can go ahead and click to submit. And that course will now be added to my schedule. However, if I would like to add more classes, I can go ahead and search again. For this next example, I'm going to go ahead and search again, and I'm going to look for a biology course. I don't know the number, so I'm going to leave that section blank, and I'm going to go ahead and click to search. Now, you can make some more room if you'd like. Scroll down and you will see a lot more options for all days and times. As you scroll through, you may find that there is a section that has no days of the week highlighted in blue. This means it is an online class, and it means that you do not meet on campus or even on the computer on a very specific date or time of the week. However, you are asked to sign into Blackboard on the first day of the session to begin your coursework. As we scroll down, you can see there are multiple pages of biology classes. So I'm going to go ahead and see if I can see more options on the page. And then as I wait for that to load, I can scroll down and I can go ahead and add a class. I see that this course has no conflicts with my schedule and it works. So I'm going to go ahead and click submit. And unfortunately, there is an error popping up. And it is saying that I did not meet the prerequisite requirement. So I may not have taken a required course that is necessary to take this specific course. If that happens to you, you can either go back and look for a different course that will meet that requirement on your degree path, or you can speak to an advisor for assistance. Now that we have selected our courses, there are two things you're going to want to do. First, you're going to want to double check your schedule and make sure that it works around your personal availability. You can also look at your schedule in greater detail. And secondly, you're going to want to look at your Degreeworks to ensure any of the courses you selected all fit within your major requirements. Lastly, if you are satisfied with your schedule, return to self-service, select schedule and options, then you may select the printer icon, and you can print out a copy of your schedule. We recognize this may be a new process for many students. So if you need any assistance with academic planning or registering for classes, contact your advisor and they'll be happy to help.